What's up, man? This is Brother Williams, and I just want to talk about this, man. Now, this is a Diddy survivor, but I want to talk about another story, which is the life she ended up going into, right? Now, this is she's going to give her background, and this is going to prove a point about just the culture that we live in and lived in. And I just need somebody to explain to me what happened to this to her. And the thing is, though, keep in mind, I ran into many women like her, and I see many women like her. So I'm trying to see what's going on. I need some solutions, but I want y'all to hear her story, right? Now, I didn't get all of it, so I'm gonna give a background. She grew up a two-parent home. She came from a Christian background, been going to church since she was 9 years old. So I need y'all to give me the breakdown of what happened, and I'm gonna give my opinion, all right? This is Brother Williams. And I'm here for the sake of the global community.
They had found out I did adult movies. They brought it to the minister, who brought it to my parents. And when I came home from work, I was working as a telemetry technician in the critical care unit at Hogue Hospital in Newport Beach. And when I came home from my shift, my parents had it on the big screen. Me with a it in my mouth.
No. Your parents had that on there?
The valedictorian, literally, the sheltered one from the suburbs who had never even had sex before in their knowledge. You know, the innocent one, their love child on the big screen with it. So when I shame my family like that.
What was that like walking into there and seeing that on the screen?
It was the worst day of my life. I still feel the memory, and it haunts me the same way Diddy haunts me to this day. I can still remember the way I felt, how my parents looked at me. You know, and then,
It's like, what more did she need? She had a two-parent home. She lived in the suburbs, because I watched the whole thing, well, most of it, in terms of her part, like the beginning part, that is. So she grew up in a two-parent home, Christian, so they have morals, in the suburbs. You know what happened to her? She got turned out by hanging around other black women who actually came from places like Compton, South Central, because she's from outside of LA. I forgot the actual suburb, but it's like another Cucamonga type situation going on, you know? And then she ended up getting turned out by some dude who played her into getting into porn, who's making money off her residuals. So it's like all that effort for nothing. Now, what she was able to do was be successful in school, but that didn't keep her from the streets. And that's how she ended up in a situation where she's being taken advantage of by a guy like P. Diddy, right? And so that's why for me, bro, I'm going to be honest with y'all, bro. You know, I refuse to raise my black daughters here, bro, because of the culture, bro. Tell me, what other excuse? What else do y'all need, bro? It's the culture. Tell me why, because I ran into a lot of women like this, man. Like, I remember, you know, my times at the strip club, I would interact with, at least four black women, and they had the same story as her, bro. Where they had two parents, and for some reason they ended up at the strip club. Not only did they have two parents, their parents were Christians, right? My boy had was dealing with a girl, just like her, you know, had an accent, a suburban accent. But she was out there in the streets too, had two parents too. I'm trying to understand what went wrong. Like, what more do we need, man? Y'all keep making us these excuses about, oh, ain't no fathers in the house. Man, when you go to these colleges, man, a lot of them women have fathers, man. Right? But the fathers are not able to control their daughters, who they deal with in the intimate on an intimate basis, man. Right? So how do you protect your daughters from ending up with thugs and no good dudes? I mean, do you gotta tell your daughters to say, hey, don't mess with black men at all? I mean, what do we supposed to do, y'all? That's what I'm trying to figure out. To prevent this from happening, because her situation, you know, I didn't watch the whole thing, the whole interview, but it seems like this could have been avoided, y'all. But yeah, this is Brother Williams.